part of a horde, of a heathen horde, aren't we? I'm proud to be a member of a heathen horde. I'm an Israeli and a Jew. I was born in Palestine because I'm older than the state of Israel, but I grew up in Israel. I want to make 3 points because I would ask to speak briefly. The first one, the impetus for this war, for this massacre, is not what you were told. It's neither the tunnels nor the rockets. What really is the impetus is a logic of elimination. Israel is determined to eliminate the Palestinian people as well as it can. Politicians have spoken recently about the need to kill all Palestinian mothers so they don't give birth to more Palestinian children. Other politicians have spoken about the need to flatten Gaza and to send Gaza, those who remain Gaza residents, to concentration camps in the south of the strip. The logic has become a logic of genocide and elimination. But there's another thing. Israel is doing what it's doing in Gaza because it needs to sustain its armament industry. Israel doing attacking Gaza every 2 years. After the attack, after the murder and massacre of so many people, Israel is holding armament trade shows. And it shows the buyers, look, it is working. Why don't you buy our products? And people buy and buy. Israel is the fourth largest producer of armaments in the world. And at the moment, it exports armaments for the value of $7 billion a year. And it exports mostly to the US, Europe, Latin America, and India. India has become a great part of Israel. This, for me, using human beings as guinea pigs for an industry is entirely unacceptable, and I'm sure you agree with me. Yeah. My second point is Israeli society, my society, which has turned increasingly fascist. Fascism is a complex concept, but according to the Israeli world expert on fascism, Israel is increasingly becoming fascist. What's happening? The few Israelis who protest in the streets are being beaten up by right-wing thugs. In fact, they roam the streets looking for so-called lefties to attack and to beat up. People who speak up are being ostracized, are being threatened. The very brave journalist Gideon Levy of Haaretz does not leave his house now. He cannot leave his house without a security guard. Haaretz is the only newspaper that keeps telling us what's really happening, and people keep calling for closing the newspaper. The point is that the fascism of Israeli society is widespread. 87 to 95% of Israelis are for the massacres and against any ceasefires. Think of it, 95% against any ceasefire, which is absurd. Now, the point is that this is added to the silence of intellectuals, so-called intellectuals. Even the famous writer Amos Oz supports the war. Yes, it is a bit excessive, he said, but he supports this massacre. And this is awful. Think of it, a society where intellectuals, writers, authors, journalists mostly support the massacre of children, women, and men. This is unacceptable, you agree with me. One final point, Israeli universities. We spoke a lot here about the need to boycott Israeli goods, but we need also to boycott Israeli universities. Not Israeli individual academics, but Israeli universities. Because they are fully complicit with the occupation. Not only do they hold special courses for armed military personnel, not only have they developed the various technological amazing weapons like the Iron Dome, like the drones, like the special robot that busts houses. Not only do social scientists devise new warfare strategies and teach soldiers how to fight. Israel, in this attack, Israel has demolished schools and attacked the Gaza, Islamic University of Gaza. Israel is not allowing academics, students, and academic and students in Palestine to do their business. Israel is against freedom of academic freedom in Palestine. So don't tell me you are embarrassed to boycott Israeli academics. Don't tell me that most academics in Israel are actually left-wing and liberal. They're not. The majority of academics keep their heads down, and those who raise their heads are being threatened with expulsion, with dismissal. The society has become entirely and utterly fascist in this respect. It's important to remember, too, that Irish University is working together with Irish University is working in, together with Israeli University. At the moment, there are 257 EU-funded projects in which Irish universities are working together with Israeli academics. It's completely and utterly unacceptable. Like Trinity College, for instance, collaborates with Israel's International Security and Counter-Terrorist Academy. Think what that may mean. Trinity College is also working together with Israel's nuclear program. Trinity College is where I work. Shame on Trinity College for this collaboration. Now, and Trinity is not the only one. UL and UCD and other universities are also...